took a walk today into the park because I'm thinking of starting this series about changes in the era of my life. Oh, cute. Kids did their little masterpieces here. Because I don't know how many people have suffered or know anyone who's suffered from eating disorders. There's different types. Some involve starving yourself to death. Some involve eating yourself to death. Some just involve like over obsessions with food, dieting, weight loss. It's all wrapped around self-image and how we view ourselves, because society really does have a big part in deciding what's pretty, what's acceptable, and how we're supposed to look. Yeah, my curiosity is getting the best of me. What's in there? Oh, stump of a tree. Beautiful. It's a really nice park out by my complex. I haven't moved yet, so this is a park that's attached to where I live. You'll find a lot of these in Oregon, and so I guess we kind of take them for granted because, you know, some people would go, why on earth would you move this from this beautiful place? But there's like hundreds of apartment complexes that have parks attached, and this is actually quite a small one, and so, you know, this isn't a deal breaker on an apartment, a deal maker. It's not a deal maker either. Anyway, I'm going to be starting a series because over the last 2 years since I turned 50, I really feel that I've reached a benchmark in my life. And it involves a lot of things, mostly my self-image and how I view myself. Because you spend so much of your youth trying to be pretty. And we get to a point in life where we have to decide, is pretty really important? What happens after pretty? I mean, does life end after pretty? Or is there more to life than just being pretty? I need to tell a little fella, curiosity killed a cat. I guess he goes, well, satisfaction brought him back. I want to know what you're doing out here with a camera at the park sitting in kids' swings. Minding my own business. Okay, this is very close. Okay, so anyway, I thought I'd take a day of reflection before I start a process. I'm getting ready to have a procedure. It's a simple procedure, the initial procedure. It's simply a endoscopy down the throat and a colonoscopy, which everyone knows what that is, and over 50 we all get scared and none of us want it. Unfortunately, none of us want it, and we kind of all end up having it. And unfortunately, some of us have it when we have to have it, as opposed to a precautionary measure. It's done because something's wrong. And in the case of us who've dealt with eating disorders 20, 30, 40 plus years, often we end up with problems in the digestion area, in the stomach area, heart area. We can end up with pulmonary issues, gastrointestinal issues, bone joint issues, fibromyalgia, strokes, heart attacks. I already said pulmonary issues. Just like when you get another dreaded disease, and like alcoholism or even a virus, and you die from complications of that virus, those complications can take on any other form, such as pneumonia or something like that. Well, an eating disorder, issues with eating and food and your intake are also, should be considered, is considered an illness. Because it's kind of stereotyped, models are rich upper class white people or whatever. It's not really brought home to the average person that anyone can have it. A lot of people just think women have it. Men have it too. Anyone can develop issues with food and self-image, because it's not just about the food, it's about self-image. And many, many, many people suffer with self-image. So when does it end? When do we finally get satisfied with ourselves and decide that it's okay? Maybe never. But even with that, we have to stop hurting ourselves. Wearing wigs, having fun doing wig reviews, makeup, clothes, whatever, that is still some image issues maybe. But it's kind of harmless in a way. Sometimes people with eating disorders are very OCD, and they just trade one obsessive compulsive disorder for another. Okay, if you can't get healed from that, okay. But just stop hurting yourself. You may start shopaholic, hurting your pocketbook, but stop hurting your health. Stop hurting yourself. And I believe I've come to an end of an era on that. I'm done hurting myself. I've been done for a while, but I didn't want to address it. And a couple years back, when I decided to lose some weight, I tried to do it in a very healthy way, and I believe I succeeded in doing it a very healthy way. Still had a lot of my OCD involved, and that's fine. You know, weighing myself every day and all that stuff, fine. But overall, what I was putting in my mouth was pretty healthy. Well, you know, day late, dollar short, I still have to deal with the repercussions of years and years and years and years of hurting myself. So this is the first video in a series of short videos that I'm going to do about this procedure I'm going through. And I'm very excited. It's not a gastric bypass. I, because of my illness, I would love one of those. People who've had one are probably going, you're nuts. But, you know, again, self-image problems that I fight. I fight all the time. I'm not looking for that. I'm looking to feel better. And yes, I still wonder how it's going to affect my weight and how I look. But I mostly want to stop the pain at this point. A lot of pain that I caused myself. So, after today, we start the prep. And it's not that bad. I don't think it's going to be that bad. The clear food, Jell-O, clear drinks. It's pretty easy for me not to eat. So, I probably will just go that route. I know that's not good, but some Jell-O and apple juice and things like that. Like the doctor laughed and goes, here's your first medically approved purge. I was like, so the prep work isn't going to be hard for me. I've been doing that. I was doing that for years, the binging and purging. So anyway, so I don't know how better I am. I really don't know if I'm better. I don't know if I'm cured. But I do know that I'm working towards good health and readjusting how I view myself. Sad, you know, and I want to do these videos too to show these young girls and any woman anywhere, anyone. I'm in my 50s and I still have issues with image, not self-esteem. It's just such thin lines between these issues. My self-esteem is okay. My confidence level is okay. It's image. How I see myself is my image. My self-esteem is fine. I'm not really concerned about how others see me. You know, it's how I see myself, how I feel about me, not in regards to someone else, but in regards to me. It's image. There's a difference. So anyway, I wanted to start the video out with this and kind of talk a little bit about that in hopes that over the next few days as I'm prepping for this, even after when I deal with the results of it, I already have gallstones. That was diagnosed about a month ago. So I am going to have the procedure to have the gallbladder removed and have the gallstones removed. And whether people want to face it or not, those of us with eating disorders, that's what those gallstones came from. They don't just necessarily come on their own. I was not greasy, fatty, spicy. I didn't eat that way. So the only other choices are the binging and purging, the losing rapid weight through starvation diets, which confuse the body, fad dieting, diet pills, diet potions, diet powders, diet drinks, on and on and on we go. So now you're going to lose an organ out of your body. Other people may say, no big deal, I don't have my gallbladder. But I'm not talking. I'm talking to people who have eating disorders who think it's okay to abuse their body for self-image, for the image of pretty. We're all going to keep getting older. And what are you going to do after pretty? What are you going to do? You need to start deciding that now. So anyway, this is the first, and they won't all be this serious, because I'm just too goofy for that. But I wanted to get on here and talk about why I'm doing it, and who I'm addressing, and the fact that I'm letting this camera be really fat, close to my fat face, and I'm not saying anything about it. I didn't wear makeup. I did put some hair on because I'm outside, but and I could have just came out without it, but I am going to go into the hospital without it. I'm going to go into hospital bald and deal with that. No makeup and all that other gobbledygook. So anyway, enjoying the day. It's a lovely day. It's a lovely day out here. Lovely day. Lovely day. Anyway, so you guys have a great day, and I'll be talking with you later. Starting tomorrow, I go from there, which is kind of hard because I'm having some allergy issues, and I'm wondering if I can take Benadryl. So I'm going to have to call the doctor and ask him about that. I don't think it's that serious, as long as I take a clear Benadryl. So anyway, talk with you later. Bye.